Welcome to ARS Biological Paradise. I am very happy to meet you again. Today, in this video, we are going to discuss about a new topic that is called Mendelian disorders. Disorder means some diseases, some abnormalities. We know all the characters because of genes. Your color, your height, your skin color or hair color or internal or external. So what are the character genes in your body because of genes? We know very well about it. Now what happens if anything changes takes place in the gene or gene structure? This leads to new character. This character will inherit to the next generation through parents to offspring. So simply you can say all the characters of the living things because of genes. If you change the genes, you can get the new character. So here what happens, the gene structure get altered or by mutation. Some disorders will lead, some diseases will form. So these diseases, because of the changes in the gene structure, is called Mendelian disorders. So you see here, alteration or mutation. Alteration or mutation occurs in a single gene. Occurs in a single gene. It gives a new character. This changes leads to some disorders. That is called Mendelian disorders. Apart from that, these disorders which is present in the parent will automatically inherited to the next generation. See here, it is inherited. Inherited means it was transferred to the offspring. So this inherited to the next generation or to offspring. This is the characteristics of Mendelian disorders. Here we are going to discuss about four important disorders which occurs due to Mendelian disorders. The one is called thalassemia. I am repeating the same term, thalassemia. Next one is phenylketonuria. So something difficult to pronunciate. So listen carefully, students. Phenylketonuria. The third one, that is called albinism. The fourth one is Huntington-chorea. Huntington-chorea. So these are the four important Mendelian disorders. Other disorders also there, we will discuss later. But in this video, we are going to discuss about these four topics. One is thalassemia. One is phenylketonuria. Third one is albinism. The fourth one is Huntington-chorea. So first one is thalassemia. This is an example for Mendelian disorders. This disorder or disease by a gene, that is called autosomal recessive gene. We know that in our body two types of cells, autosomes and allosomes. Autosome means body cells. Allosome means sex cells. Here what happens, these genes are present in body cells. So it is called what? Autosomal recessive. So we know that the dominant character, recessive characters. But this gene is a recessive gene. But present in body cells, that is called autosome. So it is called what? Autosomal recessive gene. One more. So it is an autosomal recessive gene. Thalassemia caused by dash gene. What is the answer? Autosomal recessive genes. This disease because of gene mutation. So this gene get altered. A mutation occur. Mutation means a sudden change. So because of the sudden changes or mutation, this gene causes some disorders. It's called what? Thalassemia or thalassemia. What happens because of this changes of gene structure? It results in excessive destruction of RBC. Means that RBC, red blood cells, erythrocytes, this RBC has hemoglobin, which carries the oxygen to the cells of the body. Here what happens in this patient, the RBC get destroyed. So RBC get damaged, so that there is no chance to carry the oxygen. So it leads to various complication. So main causes is results in excessive destruction of RBC. So deep RBC, all the RBC get destroyed. So it is because of abnormal hemoglobin. It is because of formation of abnormal hemoglobin. We know that hemoglobin, a red color pigment, or we can say respiratory pigment, which is present in RBC, which gives a red color also. Okay. So this formation of abnormal hemoglobin leads to disease that is called thalassemia. Once again, I am rehearsing. Thalassemia is a Mendelian disorder caused by a gene that is called autosomal recessive gene. It is because of mutation. What is the result? Destruction of RBC will occurs. Now, what is hemoglobin? We know very well about it, hemoglobin. So, this hemoglobin, two more questions they will ask. What is the structure of hemoglobin? Nothing but very simple, hemoglobin, structure of hemoglobin. This hemoglobin composed of four polypeptide chains. How many chains? Four polypeptide chains. So in each hemoglobin, four polypeptide chains are present. Out of these four, two chains are called alpha chain, and another two, they are called beta chain or beta globin chain. We can say like that. So what is hemoglobin? It is a red color pigment which is present in the RBC. So what is the structure of hemoglobin? Two more questions they will ask. What is the structure of hemoglobin? Nothing but the hemoglobin composed of four polypeptide chains. One is two alpha chain and another one is two beta chains. So what happens in this alpha chain and beta chain? Sometimes these chain get affected because of mutation. So because of the chain get affected, so it leads to thalassemia. So this is the causes of thalassemia. Dear students, now this thalassemia again has classified into two types. How many types? Two types. It is classified into two types. We already know that each hemoglobin has four polypeptide chain. Out of this, two alpha, two beta. If the alpha chain get destructed, anything changes in the abnormal condition of alpha chain, it is called alpha thalassemia. If the beta chain of the hemoglobin get infected or get altered, now this is called what? Beta thalassemia. So thalassemia is two types based on the infection of alpha or beta chains. If it is in alpha chain, it is called alpha thalassemia. If the changes takes place in the beta chain, that is called beta thalassemia. So in alpha thalassemia, this abnormalities of alpha chain of hemoglobin controlled by two closely linked genes. It is controlled by two closely linked genes. The one gene is called HBA1 and another gene is called HB2 gene. So these are the two genes which controls the normal structure of RBC or hemoglobin. Now this gene causes some abnormalities. Now it is formed alpha thalassemia. So these two genes present in chromosome number 16. So one mark again, most important point. So these genes are present in which chromosome? This is a question. Sometimes they ask. So HBA1, HBA2, these two genes are present in which chromosome, especially in the chromosome number 16. Now this gene get altered or mutation or deletion, mutation or maybe changes takes place, or maybe one chain will change or deleted, one or more of the alpha chain, alpha genes of alleles. So what happens? maybe mutation occurs in the alpha chain, or sometimes the alpha chain get deleted. So because of this condition, this type of thalassemia will occur. This is called alpha thalassemia. Once again, I am repeating. So this alpha thalassemia controlled by two closely related genes, that is called HBA1, HBA2. These two genes control the alpha thalassemia. It is present in chromosome number 16. So because of mutation or deletion of out of four chains, this causes, this type of thalassemia will cause, especially in the alpha chains of hemoglobin. The second one is beta thalassemia. We know that beta chains, two beta chains are there. If anything happens in the two beta chain, anything infected takes place, or deletion takes place, or mutation takes place. So because of deletion or mutation in the beta chains of hemoglobin, leads to a disease or disorder, this is called what? Beta thalassemia. The beta globin chain get affected. Again, this controlled by a gene that is called HBB. Here, as you can see, HBB, this is a gene which is present in the chromosome number 11. Here, these two genes are present in chromosome number 16. Here, this gene present in the chromosome number 11. So this is a one more question again. So this chromosome number 11 contains a gene that is called HBB. This gene get altered or mutated. Because of this alteration, what happens? Abnormal beta chain will form. This formation leads to a disease called what? Beta thalassemia. Are you clear, students? So this is the most common type. Out of these two types, which is the most common type? They may ask sometimes. Mention the name of the most common type of thalassemia. What is the answer? Most common type is beta thalassemia. Here what happens in this condition, in this patient, so 2 alpha, 2 beta is a normal condition. 2 alpha chains and 2 beta chains is a normal condition of a body. But what happens here? The alpha chain synthesis increased. So out of 2 alpha, 2 beta, what happens? The alpha chains may increase. So this leads to a destruction of or damage the membrane of RBC. The excess alpha chain, what happens? It causes a damage in the membrane of RBC, so that destruction of RBC will take place. This is abnormal condition. So RBC, you know that red blood cells which carries oxygen. It has outer surface. This membrane of RBC was destroyed or damaged by this type of beta thalassemia. So once again, in this topic, we have discussed Mendelian disorders. What is Mendelian disorders? Alteration or mutation in the gene structure. So this cause a disorder, this is called thalassemia, phenylketonuria, albinism, Huntington chorea. So here what is thalassemia? Thalassemia has two types of thalassemia. One is alpha thalassemia, one is beta thalassemia. So these are the important features of this unit. In next video, we are going to discuss about albinism. So what is albinism? What are the types which causes the albinism? We'll discuss. Thank you, students.